underdog is someone who triumphs in the face of rejection. When going into college, didn't know exactly what I wanted to do in my career. I'd be like, I'll just worry about my career when I'm a senior in college. And I'd expect a response back from one, when in fact, I never received a response back from any. I reached out to the recruiter, she didn't respond. I still remember pushing the days out. I knew I had to go all out. I knew that there were people who were more qualified, but I knew no one had the same work ethic as me. Because I don't look at them as simply rejections, I look at them as redirections. Today, I'm gonna tell you exactly how you can change that underdog mentality into a winning one. My name is Jonathan, and I am an underdog. Now, you're probably wondering, what is an underdog? An underdog is someone who triumphs in the face of rejection. An underdog is someone who has been through so many obstacles, but still pushes through it. An underdog are the Davids of the world versus the Goliaths. If you've ever felt this way, if you've ever felt that you've been through challenges, you've triumphed through rejections, and you feel like the Davids of the world, you've come to the right talk. Because today I'm gonna tell you exactly how you can change that underdog mentality into a winning one. Now let's flashback. Years ago, I attended UC Riverside, which was a non-target school, and came from a non-traditional background where my parents were able to migrate here years ago because my mom was a nurse and my dad was able to come because of his parents. My mom was actually the only one providing for the family. She's been a nurse, and she's helped me throughout my college career get to where I want to be. She would sell food on the streets in the Philippines just to be able to survive. And that survival instinct stuck within me, especially in my search. When going into college, didn't know exactly what I wanted to do in my career. I still remember pushing the days out. I'd be like, I'll just worry about my career when I'm a senior in college. But then I realized my first 2 years, I struggled. I struggled because I associated with those who didn't reflect who I truly was. I remember I confined to society norms and I would tell myself that I'd make it in my career, but it was only simply talk rather than action. And then that's when my last 2 years, I decided to put the foot on the gas. I put the foot on the gas, but the thing is, I'd applied to hundreds of these different roles and I'd expect a response back from one, when in fact, I never received a response back from any. And I would blame my university, I'd blame external factors that had nothing to do with my own work ethic. I'd say to myself, it's because I attend a non-target school, it's because of my background, and I'd blame my family, I'd blame my friends, when in reality, it was just me. So then that's when I changed my approach. Moving forward, when I graduated, I still remember they gave us this little piece of paper. And what it said on it was, what are you going to be doing when you graduate? I didn't have an answer for this. I didn't have really a job lined up that I was truly passionate for, but I did believe one thing. That one thing was I wanted to help people, so I wrote just that. Going into my first role, I was applying to these jobs and I found a recruiter's post on LinkedIn. A recruiter's post that simply said, I'm hiring for this role, and it was a job that I was really interested in because it was in a company and an industry that what I thought was only gonna be a dream. I reached out to the recruiter, she didn't respond. And I understood because I know recruiters get busy. But the thing was, I changed my approach again. Instead of simply saying, hey, I'm really interested in this role, I sent in my resume and reasons why I was a qualified candidate. She called me, I did really well in the first interview, and she moved me on to the final round. During the final round, I was there in person at Snapchat, a company that's well known around our community and society. I knew I had to go all out. I knew that there were people who were more qualified, but I knew no one had the same work ethic as me. So what I did was I went to Dollar Tree, I bought a yellow folder, a rectangle yellow folder, because Snapchat was yellow, and then I put my resume, my cover letter, my business cards, and I made a project in class that utilized the same technology that Snapchat used. I went to the interview. I actually had a case study that I didn't even know I was going to have, and I did exceptionally well. The two hiring managers, after presenting to them, asked me, and they were like, "Jonathan, how did you know our whole entire system?" I pulled out the yellow folder under my chair. I put it on the desk and I said, "I utilized your whole entire system in my class, utilizing geolocation technology." They looked at each other and they smiled. And after that, I received the offer in 30 minutes, the quickest offer Snap has ever given to anyone. Why I'm sharing this story is because when you get an opportunity to work in a dream company or industry that you are interested in, you go all out. You don't say to yourself, "This is just another opportunity." I remember I was feeling that same way because I exhibited that imposter syndrome in which I thought that I was never good enough to even get an interview, when in reality, you are good enough to get an interview. The thing is, you just need that chance and you need to think outside the box. And so when I was at Snap, it was a great experience, but unfortunately, I was only there for 6 months. 6 months. Our team got outsourced. I was devastated. I told myself, would I ever be able to go back into the tech industry? And so I decided to make a LinkedIn post that was as transparent as possible, but said that I was looking forward to my next opportunity, wherever it was. And what happened after that changed my life. A recruiter, a hiring manager from Google reached out to me and said, "I have this position open." I interviewed and I did exceptionally well. And that's when I was able to get my foot the door at Google and move to the Bay Area in hopes of pursuing that dream in tech in the Silicon Valley. My time at Google was great. I was there for under 2 years. There's so many amenities, free food, working out, good friends. But the thing was, when I was there, I didn't see anybody that was just like me. I didn't see anybody from these non-target schools. I thought to myself that I was not good enough to be there, and I exhibited that imposter syndrome I said before. I exhibited it because I thought that I was never good enough. And that's what affected me. During my time there, I still remember I gained 15 pounds. I thought that I wasn't good enough. But the thing was, when I spoke to my friends, I'd be like, "I'm the best." When in reality, just because you work at a big company does not mean you're the best. I think what happens in society nowadays is that we base people off the companies that they work for rather than the character that they exhibit. And that's what I exhibited. I didn't exhibit a good character at that time. And that's exactly why I left. I left, but then I left to go to another company, a company that I was interested in too as well. And you know how I got there? LinkedIn. So when I first started at Cisco in the strategy and operations field, it was fun. What I did was I made a LinkedIn post that showed my whole entire career story going from UCR to Cisco. And LinkedIn CEO at the time, Jeff Weiner, recognized it and shared it. And that's how everybody knew me at Cisco. That's when I was joined the family. I did so many amazing things, but the thing was, I also did Wonsulting. I started Wonsulting at Google, but then I started to scale it up when I was at Cisco because I knew that my dream was to help people, as I wrote on that piece of paper. Unfortunately, what happened was this past February, my team got affected by Cisco layoffs, specifically with the pandemic. You're probably wondering, this guy's the worst luck. He's getting laid off and getting affected by COVID-19. But the thing was, what I look at is not at these rejections. I don't look at them as simply rejections. I look at them as redirections, as long as you can react to it in the correct way. And that mindset has driven me to do so many different things. After getting affected by Cisco layoffs, I worked on Wonsulting. We started the speaker series where we've had over hundreds of thousands of attendees. Started partnering with companies and organizations. Over 150 now so far I've spoken at in 8 different countries. We've impacted hundreds of thousands of lives and helped them get jobs at the Googles, the Lloyds, the Goldman Sachs of the world in a time where people are getting layoffs and furloughed. We then provided 4,500 opportunities for those affected by those layoffs and furloughs and brought companies to come recruit them. Why I'm telling you this story is because of the mindset aspect of it. When you get rejected, when you get affected by something within that is without control of your own emotions or your own feelings or what you do, if you react to it in the correct way, you can get somewhere. And that's what I did. And because of that, I was actually able to do Wonsulting full time. Key takeaways from all of these different things I've mentioned. Number one, your mindset is extremely important. Will you look at your rejection and say, I'm not good enough? Will you look at your rejection and say, I am good enough, and I'm gonna prove exactly why? That change in mindset is extremely important, especially when getting into your career. Number two, networking is essential. It is essential because networking gets your foot in the door at a company or in your career or just with insight. I still remember I was trying to figure out, how do I network? I don't share anything in common with anybody. But the thing is, you all do. What you share in common is you're human and you're watching this talk today. You're watching this talk, meaning you're hardworking, meaning you are trying to look at the next steps in your career. And you're putting your best foot forward. Last but not least, number three, associate with those who reflect who you are. Associating with those who aren't a good influence will cause you to be a bad influence in society. But if you associate with those who motivate you and get you to where you want to be, but then you also give back to the community, that is exceptional to say the least. So be sure to hang with those that you love and love what you do with the people you love. That's what I always stress. Love what you do. I love what I do. I love speaking to students and job seekers. I love making LinkedIn content. I love hosting speaking engagements. I probably love you for watching this talk. At the end of the day, we are all underdogs. But the thing is, how will you become a winner? And I'll leave it at that. The mindset. Push hard to where you want to be, because that dream can become a reality. My name is J-Well, and I was an underdog. And now I'm a winner. What will your story be?
Tell us what you think about this video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.